8th, and we're at on the old highway at Raymond, Illinois, heading northeast. A group of high school kids gathered money and built a shrine for travelers on the highway here, and the same man still upkeeps it, and his family still upkeeps it. The interstate's roaring next to me, but there's the old highway. Is Mary, loving mother of Jesus, protect us on the highway, erected by Litchfield Deanery Catholic Youth Council, dedicated October 25th, 1959. There's Mr. Marten.
Yeah.
Hi, you're the guy in the picture. We were afraid we were going to wake somebody up.
No, you ain't going to wake nobody up.
No.
Hi.
Yeah, probably four you guys do.
Oh, look at that. You even got your Route 66 Hall of Fame thing on the wall.
That's up there to McLean, Illinois. They got that up there.
Oh, yeah, we're on our way up there.
They've got that up there. Mm-hmm. No? Picture is this. Me, just like I am.
Yeah, it looks just like you.
About all like. Hey, sit down, you guys, you want to.
Yeah, we were just, we were traveling the highway from California.
California?
Yeah, and that 59 Cadillac out there.
Yeah, boy, that's an antique, ain't it?
Yeah.
Boy, that's a good one, all right.
It drives good, though.
Yeah, I'd say so.
But,
You're going on up the other end north.
That's yeah, that's where we're going.
You started out on the other end,
then. Uh-huh. Yeah. But,
How long you been on the road?
We left a week ago today.
Oh.
Yeah.
You're having a good trip then.
Oh yeah, it's fabulous. I did it last year and I had so much fun that I brought another friend of mine to do it.
It's a darn hot in through here this time.
Do you know this is the first day in the whole week that it's been overcast?
I know it is. First day we had any decent weather. It's been terrible. It was 94 or 5 here yesterday.
Oh, wow.
It's about 80 something today though.
My goodness.
It's around close to 80, I guess. We're in there.
Okay. Yeah. Boy, it must be nice and quiet out here.
Yeah. Well, I'm here alone. My wife died 8 years ago, and I never remarried. There was somebody anybody I was interested in.
That's
my family back there on the wall.
I saw those pictures. You got quite a family.
Yeah. Well, 6 boys and 2 girls, and I got 24 grandchildren.
My gosh. You must have people coming in and out of here all the time.
Oh, I do. I have quite a bit of company. I'm retired. I'll be 80 years old before too long. And my boys do the farming, and I help them a little to what I can, you know. But I keep a cane around. I'm off the cane and I'm outside around the house. I get out all right.
Huh.
The CYO kids erected that in 59. That's a Catholic youth organization and of several parishes around here. It's a Litchfield Deanery. Litchfield is about 10 miles down south here. And they took care of it, the flowers, and keep it washed about once a year or so. And only for 5 years that lasted. And then some moved away, and one died, and some got married, you know, and it's kind of lost interest, and it just left it up to me then. So I've been taking care of it all but 5 years myself, and keep lights on it out there, and put about 2 or 3 bouquets of flowers on it every year out there. And the lights cost me about I guess about $5,000 or $6,000. Yeah, no more than that. I just can't think. About $50 a year, I guess, about for the electricity out there. I did have it on a meter or so, but then you had to pay so much for each meter, so I had it disposed of and hooked it on my house meter, but I don't know what it was before.
Right.
So they charge you so much for a meter, whether you use it or not, REA light company does.
Yeah, last year I drove by and it was just about getting dark, and I was on the interstate right out in front, and it was I could see it lit up.
Well, it's got a time clock out there. It gets dark while it comes on, and then it gets daylight while it turns it off.
Yeah.
the bulbs out there. It takes about four to six bulbs a year, and they cost $6 to $7 a piece.
Mm-hmm.
Those lights. Mm-hmm. And then there's a dealer in town here, electrician, and he's not a Catholic either, and he gives them to me at wholesale. I think it's $6 and something, $6.49. But I take there's 12 in a case. I take 12 at a time, you know. And he just gives them to me just wholesale. Like, well, he says what it costs him, and I he's a decent kind of a guy. I think he would.
So I imagine you have quite a few people stopping in.
A lot of people. Mm-hmm.
Just coming up to see. Mm-hmm. We weren't sure we were going to bother you, you know, but we...
Well, it don't bother me at all. But I don't have nothing else to do, you know. I helped the boys in the field yesterday a little bit, but today, you know, there ain't much going on. The town paid my taxes this morning. I'm just glad to have company.
Oh, yeah.
You know,
well, would you like to sign our books?
Well, sure.
Yeah.
Sure. I've signed only a few thousand already.
Well, I have signed quite a few of them. I don't mind at all. I don't know, I'm kind of, every picture you'll ever see of me will be in overalls, because I like I told my kids, I says, I must have been born in overalls. I didn't know if I was or not, but I said, I'd like to be buried in them. So I wasn't it. I'm born on a farm, and I've lived on the farm all my life. I've never been anywhere else. I'm satisfied this way.
Oh, it's so nice and peaceful out here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. A lot of traffic goes by on this road here. What about just my name or an address, too? Or
sure.
Address?
There was a bunch of motorcycles. There must have been, there must have been 20 or 30 of them. And they were just outside, you know, parking with their motorcycles. You get your first impression is that, oh, they're going to be wild.
They're not all rough because they got on black jackets and stuff. But now that bunch stopped here is just a pretty nice bunch. I think it's these two women with them, not three. They was a civilized bunch.
Well,
I'm just what I am. If I get dressed up, it's just to go to church or something. As soon as I get home, them good clothes comes off, and I get in overalls.
There you go.
I'm more comfortable.
The idea is to be comfortable.
Well, that's the main thing. You know, go down there and look at the pig if you can. That's California. Right straight on behind that ground.
Oh, yeah, right there.
Oh, okay.
The white one.
Yeah. Okay. There's something there.
Well, it's starting to warm up.
Oh. It'll be up to 90 by 2:12.
Yeah.
Some smaller pigs there, and then there's some bigger ones. If you want to see them, some people take pictures of them, but just to go around behind that shed there.
Oh, behind this one?
Yeah.
Okay.
There's a bunch of pigs down there, and there's some little ones down there.
All right, we'll go take a look.
Okay.
They might think it's time to eat. Look at that. Hi, pig. Hi.
They don't know what that thing is that you have in your hand.
They think it's eating time. How funny. They just roll around and lay in mud. Here comes the tractor.
He's got a wife and three kids. One lives right here in Raymond, that's 4 miles. He's got a family of four, three, I think. Between here and Litchfield, there's two boys. Oh, and another in Raymond, too.
They're all close by, yeah.
Yeah. Well, I got two out in Indiana. A girl and a boy out in Indiana. But then I got a girl in Springfield. They're all around here, so see them every week. Every Sunday, we generally get together and have a deal here in town. There's a couple of good restaurants.
Uh-huh. Well, this is a really nice, I'm glad we stopped. Really nice.
Yeah.
Thanks for giving us your time.
Well, that's okay. Yeah. Well, I mowed a little out here last night. Mosquitoes got so damn bad I couldn't hardly put up with mosquitoes. So.
Yeah, we noticed it was mowed up really nice.
Oh, I was putting up the things about the